I'm Liz. You may know me from this.
And guess what? I've been hired! Well, sort of.
I'm going to be an apprentice at some of Singapore's oldest businesses.
I broke it.
It was so nice!
To explore how they're finding new ways of doing old things. In this episode, I become an apprentice to a traditional soy sauce maker.
Wow, it's not really like sauna.
And learn how their handmade recipe is being threatened by mass production.
I think this one will be pretty easy. There's no way I can mess this up.
I hear there's something special about this bar chor mee that makes it different from the others. Apparently, their secret ingredient is a special sauce. To find out what it is, I am traveling to the industrial estates of Jurong. Because here, behind this metal gate, is a family-owned factory that is brewing something special. For the next few days, I'm going to learn the ropes of soya sauce making here at Nanyang Sauce. And I'm dipping into the business in the best way possible, with food.
Okay, let's start with the eggs.
The smell is already amazing.
It's not just salty. Real soya sauce, good soya sauce is
umami.
Umami, yeah. Right? Which is that extra fragrance that you smell. One of the food that is best to go with light sauce or dark sauce is eggs. Because eggs by itself, there's no natural taste, which is good, because a good sauce will be able to carry the taste.
Nanyang Sauce was founded in 1959 by Ken's grandfather, Tan Tiong Hao, who came from a long line of soya sauce makers in Fujian, China. When Tiong Hao migrated here, he brought with him the secret family recipe, which is still used to hand-brew traditional soya sauce today.
When he came here, he could only bring a small packet of the koji. And he started brewing from home because to flavor his porridge that he was eating.
Yeah.
Yeah. And, okay. You know, and then he started giving to his friends. And his friends said, hey, this is good. This reminds me of the soya sauce I had back home. Right? And then they said, hey, why don't you make more? Start buying from him.
The second generation of Ken's family took over in the 80s, but by this time, their sauces were facing some stiff competition.
After the 80s and the 90s, you have a lot of brands going the mass-produced way, and then very small number of endangered species sauce makers that still retain the old way. For us, up to a point about 5 years ago, in 2017, my mum and her brothers also almost wanted to stop and sell it off.
觉得好像很累，就对，很累了。因为年纪的，好像说又有人他要来过我们买了。所以你说起初没有想卖，可是有人想买。嗯，因为我在这边工作了很多年，嗯，讲讲都是有一份感情的。对。啊，所以要卖又舍不得。
5 years ago, so this was right before you joined.
Yes, 2017.
Okay, is that what prompted you to quit your other business and join them because they wanted to stop this?
Yes, I felt it would be such a waste. So then I saw it as a sign for me to come back into the business and help. Mm-hmm. Maybe keep it going or do something about it. Mm-hmm. Or at least find out why we are losing money every year. So I went on a sauce brewery tour around Asia. So I visited 13 sauce breweries. From Malaysia to China to Philippines, Japan, so on and so forth, you name it. And at the end of the tour, I had a conclusion. I understood why we are losing money. Nobody was taking 9 months to make soya sauce. And that was an aha moment for me. I said, well, then does the world know the difference? The golden question was, are people willing to pay a few dollars more for an old school sauce?
Modern mass-produced soya sauce is made by hydrolysis, a chemical process which breaks down the proteins in soybeans. Whereas traditional methods use koji, a type of mold that starts the fermentation process. The difference? Hydrolysis takes days compared to the 9 months that Nanyang Sauce takes to make their condiments. Which is why each bottle of handmade sauce costs around $12 compared to an average of $3 for a mass-produced one.
So now that I've had a taste of the soy sauce, I can definitely taste the difference. But to fully understand how tedious this process is, I will have to roll up my sleeves and get my hands dirty. Let's do this! Ah, auntie, pass ma.
你真漂亮.
There, yeah?
Nanyang Sauce only brews their sauce a few times a year. I'm in luck because today happens to be Brewing Day. To make soy sauce, it all starts with steaming the soybeans.
蒸半个小时.
Okay.
这个黄豆是用纯 no GMO 加拿大特选的黄豆，然后一次煮就是要煮这么多，给你猜，可以吗？
啊，弟，你很 strong
哎。开始的时候我是像你这样哦，也是这个是慢慢学的。
慢慢学 ，OK。
啊，要给它有空间冷却。
Cooling the beans is essential, so it won't kill the live koji when it is added later.
所以你父亲是第一代，然后师傅你是第二代。那你为什么决定接管你爸爸的生意？
不然这个门手工酿造，越南酿造的酱油就会失传了嘛。对了，就这样一代一代传下来。Ken
起初要变成第三代的时候，你有点不愿意让他开始，为什么呢？好像你这样觉得很辛苦吗？
No，
不会，哈，父母亲都是希望这样的，不希望孩子太过累了，所以如开始的时候我是好像不大愿意，后来他一直坚强哦，他要进来做，我就放手给他做了，放这个粉给他发酵，ferment，
呀，啊，OK，
然后加一点点的酵素。
The koji kickstarts the fermentation process, similar to yeast in bread making. The koji is what gives the handmade soy sauce its distinct flavor. In 3 days, these soybeans will turn green. After that, they'll be put into the vats where the fermentation will continue. But that's work for another day.
So far, it's been tiring, it's labor intensive, and it's been a lot of hard work. And now I can fully understand why they have been pricing their soy sauce a little bit more expensive as compared to the others in the market. And I'm very curious to see how Ken has been trying to market his premium soy sauce.
I'm back at Nanyang Sauce. My task today is to show some tender, loving care to vets. There are about 200 vets in this brewery, each carrying 100 liters of soy sauce. Most of these are the same vets that Ken's grandfather used in 1959.
So Liz, this is where the magic happens. For the next 9 months, after the beans have come to the vets, they will be fermented and we'll care for them daily. As part of caring for the vets, we visit them every day, and the beans know when I'm here and when I'm not here.
I see.
So I open them, and I'll talk to them.
Okay, what do you say?
Hello, how are you today? You know, how's the fermentation, you know?
Okay.
Yeah, it's something that people can't understand. But if you think of it as a living thing,
right?
If you think of it like a pet, we got to nurture them with love.
Yes. Hello, I am Elizabeth, but you can call me Liz. Please ferment well, and I will see you guys very soon, okay? Have a good day.
Oh, that's the extra. This one will be extra sweet.
While in the vat, enzymes from the koji break soy and wheat proteins down into amino acids. Starch in the beans is converted into simple sugars, then fermented to become light soy sauce. Dark soy sauce is soy sauce that has been aged longer and mixed with molasses.
So this business was started by your grandfather.
He's an artist, more than a businessman. For example, there was an incident in 1995 when I was still in primary school, and he had a meeting. And one of the things I like to do is to sit beside him while he has his meeting, right?
Okay.
And pretend to be boss. That was a meeting that
he met with a group of consultants mm-hmm. that were trying to teach him to use the fast commercial
I see.
Chemical process yeah. that were shortened 9 months to as short as a day.
Yeah.
After the meeting, he got really angry. He stood up and he pointed at me. You know, as if I don't dare to feed my grandson this new soy sauce that you are teaching me to make, how can I feed the rest of Singapore? And he told the guys to get out. So I think that principle has ring true to this day, mm-hmm. where we don't sell things that we don't dare to eat ourselves.
Yes.
When I first came to a business, mm-hmm. it was very perplexing for me because we wouldn't have the full company name. Okay. We would just have like Atan, Aheng, Aseng.
Okay, you know? So right. So there was no database.
It took us a good 6 to 7 months to profile every one of our customers into an Excel, you know, so mm-hmm. that we know who are our customers, the contact number, the address, yep. what were their purchases.
Yeah.
And that was a very, very big step for us.
After that, Ken spent 5 years trying different ways to rejuvenate Nanyang Sauce as a premium artisan sauce maker. And finally, in 2021, his efforts paid off when the company managed to turn a profit. Now, things have changed so much that some people buy soy sauce just like whiskey, by the barrel. Or, should I say, vat.
This is the world's first bespoke service by Nanyang Sauce, where we are able to customize the taste profile for customers. So we have a taste matrix of 8 parameters and then we will do sampling and tasting with the customer first.
How much would it cost to customize a vat for yourself?
It starts from $10,000 a vat, Sing dollars.
Okay, I was thinking of buying a vat for my family. You know, I think my grandma would have really enjoyed it, but it's a little bit steep for me.
For the business to survive, they've had to broaden their customer base. That meant selling their sauces online and getting onto select supermarket shelves.
Is this part of your job scope every single day?
Yes, this is part of what we call merchandising and stock take. So we'll visit stores, like Simpopo here is our distributor, uh-huh. and then we'll write orders to replenish and we'll help to stock up.
How often do you do this?
I do this on a weekly basis. Sam, just curious, how's the sales this month?
We really got lots of people asking for our 12-month brew. I think that's really popular. And also the set of 5. So that's what a lot of customers are going for. So we'll probably need to restock one of those as well. We met Ken about 3 years back and we really loved the idea of local sauce maker. They've got a strong following. Some people carry overseas.
Yeah.
And some just gift them, you know, like mom-in-law.
The gift set one.
Yeah, for dinner. So they have a nice set.
Now that they've built a presence in Singapore, Ken tells me that his current venture is to open a brewery in Bhutan. Chosen because of the country's pristine natural resources and easy access to Himalayan salt.
Okay, so Liz, tomorrow I'm flying back to Bhutan.
Tomorrow.
So I leave you in the good hands of my mom to teach you how to make soy sauce.
Oh, we're in very good hands. Don't worry. She'll take care of me and I'll take care of her.
So all the beans that we prepared 3 days ago are ready. And this is all thanks to the koji and a flour that we massaged into them. Do you guys remember? Oh my gosh, I can't believe it. They're all done.
Ooh. Now we're like this. You can see, this is slowly down.
Under my master's watchful eye, I spend the afternoon transferring trays of soybeans into vats. With each vat, we are making enough soy sauce to eventually fill around 200 bottles.
One more down!
This is the last one. This is the last one.
Also, a pro tip, don't have long nails while doing this. It makes it very difficult.
I have torn through the gloves with my nails.
9 months from now, this is what you'll get. Rich, fragrant soy sauce. And this is crazy to me, every single bottle of Nanyang sauce is bottled and labeled by hand.
I'll teach you how to make it.
Okay.
Okay.
I think this one will be pretty easy. There's no way I can mess this up.
Now you have to put in the middle. Look, it's from Singapore.
Okay.
师傅，你的顾客是谁？我的顾客难免都是好像老一辈的。可是你觉得年轻人还会舍得买吗？年轻人他们只要品质好，味道好，好吃，他们都会买的。
With Auntie Po Chu's vote of confidence, I'm going to learn how Nanyang Sauce is enticing younger customers to buy their sauce. Okay, so brewing soy sauce has been fun, but today, General Manager Jenny has a task for me that I might actually be good at. Making TikTok videos.
Are you trying to go for something that's more funny, that's more serious? What exactly do you have in mind?
Funny? Something interesting?
I think I do have an idea in mind, so let's see if we can try this one out.
Sure.
Okay?
What we are promoting is Nanyang Sauce's new line of youth-oriented condiments called Secret Umami.
Secret Umami is what we have designed. It's a dipping sauce designed specially for people who don't cook, but they love to eat, and we have earth, fire, water, and air.
Each flavor is soy sauce mixed with various herbs and aromatics to complement a cooking method.
Water. Earth. Fire.
This video is going on Nanyang Sauce's TikTok channel.
Video, very funny.
For my hard work making TikToks all afternoon, Jenny has invited me over for hot pot.
Water is specially made for hot pot.
How would you describe the taste of water?
It actually blends very, very well with seafood, like prawns, fish. For older generations, usually they have their own favourite brands and their own recipes that they will always follow. But young people, they are more adventurous. We have to keep innovating because we are tapping on a very big group of audience that it is left untapped. Mm. If they like our sauce, they will be with us for the next 20, 40, 50 years.
How are you intending to capture the younger audience with Secret Umami?
Besides the social media like TikTok, Instagram, also we will be doing NFT.
NFT as well?
Yes.
Okay, hold up. What? To find out more, Jenny has asked me to meet Ian Lo, one of the chefs who is Nanyang Sauce's first NFT partner. Ian is a home cook who makes online videos under the moniker The Silver Chef. He has over 100,000 followers on Instagram. Ian is showing me the chicken rice paste recipe that he gave to Nanyang Sauce. They turned it into an NFT, which is a trademark of sorts, and mass-produced the sauce for sale.
Put inside the rice cooker.
Ian keeps some of the proceeds and Nanyang Sauce expands its repertoire.
So you're making this into an NFT?
It's actually not the sauce that's NFT, it's the recipe that we're making into an NFT.
Ian, what's the process to creating your NFT like?
Okay, so creating NFT is basically quite straightforward in the sense that I need to detail the recipe itself. So on top of that, okay, we need to give Ken things like pictures. Mm-hmm. So from Ken's side, he will work with his people to mint, it's what we call mint the NFT. So
right.
Create the NFT itself into an asset that can go into the NFT market.
So you're basically saying I can start a business and make money from this NFT?
Possible.
What a great deal! Do you think that this will help Nanyang Sauce attract a younger crowd?
Well, actually, to be honest, it can be boundless because we have quite a few recipes that we can use. For example, if you say, if I take a jajangmyeon, for example. You know jajangmyeon Korean?
I love.
Now, if you think about jajangmyeon, the KL Tai Lok Mee, the Hokkien noodle, black color noodles.
Yes.
There's also similar ingredients in the sauce, but there's fine tweaks and refinements. Mm. So there could be two different NFTs instead of one.
Yeah.
So that's why when I say that there's boundless, we can have more fun with coming up with old traditional recipes and turning it into NFTs from there.
What I'm going to do now is I'm going to go home and ask my mom or my grandma if they have any family recipe for sauces that I can go mint.
Yes.
A And where would I sell Liz's grandma's secret NFT sauce? I have one last place I have to visit before the end of my time with Nanyang Sauce.
Hi, Liz.
Jenny!
Hello!
Hi, how are you? So this is the sauce legend shop I've heard so much about.
Yes, welcome!
Nanyang Sauce's concept store, Sauce Legend, opened in Jewel at the end of April 2022. The idea behind it? To sell not just their traditional sauces, but also their NFT sauces.
So everything here,
yes.
Inspiring new sauce NFTs as well. Open me? Can I?
Yes! Take a
oh
deep breath.
Oh my gosh! Wow, the smell is really strong.
It is a vat of soy sauce brought from the factory.
This is to let people see and understand that we are still using this very big part to make our sauces. So this is the Golden Swan brand by Nanyang Sauce, and then we have some of the old sauce that we bring in from overseas.
Okay, this is what I'm familiar with. This is the one that I helped to bottle and put the sticker on at the factory.
Yes.
Hey, this is Ian's sauce. You're selling it in this shop as well.
Yes.
Oh my gosh, and the chicken rice photo looks exactly like the one that we made the other day.
So I started off my apprenticeship with the very traditional way of making soy sauce, the whole fermentation process, and that was really painstakingly laborious. And now I feel like I've gone into the future of soy sauce, you know, which is NFTs, the metaverse, and we have a physical shop here in Jewel that is dedicated to sauces. So while the future is uncertain, and I'm not sure if Ken's really ambitious plans will succeed, what I can say is that I am definitely on their side. And the only thing left is to return to the factory 9 months from now and see how my vats of soy sauce turns out.